Hi guys, Jackie is back. This week we're gonna watch an American crime film, Swordfish. Stanley is a very excellent hacker. Years ago, he broke into a security system that the FBI is intensely proud of. It's also the cause that sent him into jail. At this time, his wife and son moved to live with another rich person. When he's released on parole, Stanley's even prohibited using phone or any electric devices, plus, he can't get out of a specific area. One day, a girl named Ginger finds Stanley. Ginger knows that Stanley is trying to fight for custody of his daughter. But he can't compete with his rich wife. Ginger suddenly gives Stanley $100,000, but Stanley has to meet her boss. Whether he agrees with her boss's condition or not, he also can get this sum of money. Besides, he also needs lots of money if hiring a lawyer. Such a poor wretch like Stanley has no reason to reject Ginger. The boss Gabriel is an important person. He wants to test if Stanley is really an excellent hacker or not. Stanley has just arrived. Gabriel points a gun into his head and intimidating him to unlock the National Defense Database in 60 seconds. Stanley has no choice, he has to use all his skills to save his life. Actually, his reputation is not fake. Although Stanley hasn't done it for a long time, but he still unlocks successfully within 60 seconds. It's totally out of Gabriel's expectation. He's sure that Stanley is exactly the one he's searching for. But Stanley just wants to leave here as soon as possible. Ginger chases after him and persuades him to stay. Facing such a wealthy wife, he will never be able to get custody just with 100,000 bucks. Stanley has to get more money to succeed in this. And Gabriel is his only choice now. After considering, Stanley accepts this deal. Under Gabriel's order, if Stanley decodes the bank encryption program of the central bank, he can get 10 billion bucks. No matter how hard it is, but it's just like a piece of cake with Stanley. Stanley really misses his daughter. He borrows a luxurious car from Ginger to meet his daughter. Unexpectedly, the FBI has found out Stanley entered the country via camera, and the one who arrested him that year is deputy director of the FBI. The black policeman's really worried about that news. He also comes to this situation a couple of days ago. Eventually, the hacker is killed secretly. He supposes Stanley's arrival this time is also not that simple. He orders his lackey to investigate his former wife. Stanley has just brought his daughter home, when the FBI appears. Knowing himself has violated the rule, he immediately finds a way to escape. The police try their best to chase and intercept him. Eventually, they catch him. But the black policeman doesn't intend to arrest Stanley, he just wants to know what exactly his purpose is. Stanley won't tell him the truth for sure. But before leaving, he still leaves Stanley his name card, and don't forget to warn him one hacker has been killed recently. And persuading him to think throughout and contact him. Returning home, Stanley catches sight of Ginger changing clothes, and finding a tapping device on her body. Stanley is really amazed, he questions who Ginger really is. Gabriel finds it out. Ginger has to admit that she is a spy of the Drug Enforcement Administration. She just wants to gather proof to arrest Gabriel. She wants Stanley to quickly decode the system and take money, staying away from this danger. Gabriel suddenly appears, but Stanley doesn't reveal the real background of Ginger. He secretly puts the tapping machine into his pocket. Gabriel tells him there will be a swordfish event. The puppet company will secretly gather evidence of the drug cartel. These years, this company has got about $400 million from this. After that activity, this whopping sum of money will take interest in secret. Up to the present, this number has reached roughly $9.5 billion. Gabriel is just a special agent in this chain. He wants Stanley to help him attack the security system of the bank. And stealing this black money away. One day, the FBI finds Gabriel and Stanley together. Around them are all mercenaries. Besides, the villa also emits very strong heat. It might be a large-scale engine. It's clear that they are plotting something unlawful. The FBI reports this affair to the senator. Unexpectedly, the senator is also on the same side as Gabriel. He tells Gabriel to stop his plan, but this thing is already out of his control. Gabriel knows he can't do anything. He insists on taking all this black money. The senator's really unsatisfied with it. He orders his lackeys to get rid of Gabriel in secret. They must strangle him in some way. That time, Stanley almost can decode the system successfully. When he's finding some wine to relieve stress, he suddenly catches sight of something like Gabriel's dead body. Stanley's really scared out of his wits. This time, Gabriel comes up, seeing Stanley's scary look, he really wants to know what happened. He takes Stanley out for a drive. He tells Stanley about a magician and a cover-up. Stanley turns confused, he really doesn't know what Gabriel really wants. Suddenly, they notice someone is following behind. Gabriel steps on the throttle and accelerates. But the street is too crowded for them to escape. He has to think of another way. He lets Stanley take control of the steering wheel, then getting rid of two drivers on both sides. They stop the car and take a machine gun full of bullets out of the car boot. and killing the chasers. Stanley gets in the car and risks his life to escape. After a while, their car gets cornered to the dead alley. This time, Gabriel has got rid of almost all chasers. He picks up a gun and handles the rest. It turns out the dead body in this car is the senator's lackeys. He's really mad, directly finds a senator to get rid of. Finally, Stanley succeeds in decoding the system. As their agreement, Gabriel promises to give Stanley 10 billion right that time. But things are not that easy. Gabriel claims to have 10 great dreams, using violence to curb violence, preventing terrorism from harming national security. If terrorists drop one bomb, he will drop 10. If they hijack the aircraft, he will burn down the airport. If they execute visitors, he will destroy a city with them. Gabriel thinks it needs to take power to defeat power. Only in this way, terrorists are still overpowered and don't dare to attack the nation. That sum of black money is also the military expenditure for them to protect the nation. So Stanley has to complete this mission with the bank. Gabriel promises after all money is successfully transferred, he definitely can start a new life with his daughter. This kind of absurd logic just makes no sense to Stanley. In the first place, Stanley agrees to help decode the system because he's unsatisfied with the way the FBI supervises illegally the private information of residents. A person like Stanley never wants to associate with an evil person like Gabriel. He cuts electric lines and escapes from the arsenal. Gabriel doesn't chase him because he knows clearly that Stanley never can get out of his control. As expected, when Stanley comes to pick up his daughter, he finds his former wife's house all killed, daughter is out of trace. To get Stanley into the trap, Gabriel has prepared all these things. On this side, Gabriel sends out 4 cars, breaking the bank and kidnapping 22 hostages. They are stuck with 20 dynamites and 15 steel balls on their body. It can be said to be the strongest destructive power mine ever. If coming out of limits, they will immediately explode. When the black policeman is negotiating with Gabriel, one soldier takes action without his permission, commanding his peers to get rid of the sniper outside. He falls down, then the hostage runs into the bank to escape. But she was taken back by the police beside her. The black policeman tells them to immediately stop, but it's too late. They explode right at that time and scraps from steel balls sputter out. The innocent victims are endless. Stanley gets here and witnesses the tragedy. Gabriel's really furious, he commands the police to let the plane get to the airport in 25 minutes. Stanley has to help Gabriel to steal money after seeing his daughter being kidnapped right before his eyes. Via breaking the system and decoding password, Stanley quickly transfers 9.5 billion to Gabriel's account. Right at the time, Stanley leaves with his daughter, Gabriel finds all his money disappears. Stanley stops the robber to let his daughter escape. Without intimidation, Stanley isn't scared of Gabriel anymore. This sum of money will be transferred to a different account every minute. He says no hackers can withdraw this money except him. But he has a condition, Gabriel has to release all the hostages. But he doesn't care, he arrests Ginger, and threatens Stanley to immediately get this money back within 60 seconds. Or else she will be hanged till death. Ginger is just a spy of the Drug Enforcement Administration, she's also a righteous person like him. Under this intensive press, Stanley has to transfer this money from across the world back to his account. After finishing, Gabriel gets rid of Ginger with one shotgun. It turns out he has known this girl as a spy. Stanley then gets escorted to a car, Gabriel's lackeys even arrange rockets right behind him. These cars start driving towards the airport. On the way, Stanley asks Gabriel why he doesn't have any guilty feelings for all these things. Gabriel simply answers, if killing an unlucky little girl can get rid of all diseases, will he agree? Stanley, no way. But it's basically a perspective of Gabriel. He thinks if he can protect residents, it's worth killing thousands of people. He even wants to buy a nuclear bomb, and risks his life with them. What he said terrifies Stanley, he is still a scary terrorist. If Stanley doesn't kill him, he will feel guilty a lot. The car's about to arrive at the airport when it changes direction. An ambushing plan of the police seems to be ruined. After a while, a helicopter appears and drops off 4 steel cables. Robbers stick them to 4 corners of the car, then, the helicopter lifts it up to the sky, letting them escape successfully. But, because of strong wind, the fly is affected, that car hits a building and drops 1 cable, making it almost fall down. Finally, the helicopter still puts it safely on the top of the building. Gabriel turns off dynamites on hostages, and gets on another helicopter, intends to escape. Stanley can't stand seeing the jerk escape right before his eyes. He suddenly remembers the rocket launchers on the car. Stanley carries on and shoots towards the helicopter, making it explode. Then, the police call him over to recognize Gabriel. Depending on half of his face, he can be sure it's him. A policeman comes, telling black policeman Ginger's dead body disappeared, plus, the Drug Enforcement Administration also doesn't find any information about her. At that moment, Stanley seems to realize what's happening. he remembers of the cover-up Gabriel told him about. Ginger revealed his background and persuaded him to decode the system as soon as possible, about the faces strikingly similar to Gabriel. And the moment when the bomb explodes, he did see someone go downstairs. Stanley can be sure that Gabriel hasn't died, but the black policeman doesn't think so. To keep a safe life for his daughter, Stanley doesn't want to discuss more than that. He brings his daughter far away with $10 million. Ginger withdraws $9.5 billion in the other country. She and Gabriel start carrying out their exploit plan. The terrorists also begin their darkest life ever. Okay, that's the end of this movie. Don't forget to like, share, comment. Jackie will be back soon.